In this video, we're gonna learn how to differentiate between canker sore and herpes. We will learn how doctors tell the difference between those two common conditions in real life. My name is SlavaFuzayloff, and I'm the physician at STD Center, one of the biggest centers in New York City, located in Midtown Manhattan. Let's start. Why it's important to differentiate between those two common conditions, herpes and canker sores? Both conditions are common. Both conditions can affect people of different ages and genders. Both conditions can look alike, but herpes, unlike canker sore, is infectious conditions and can be transmitted skin-to-skin contact. And herpes, unlike canker sore, once you get it, you have it for life and it stays for life with you. And you're going to have occasional flare-up. How doctors differentiate between those two conditions, herpes and canker sore? We usually consider two things in combinations: visual exam of the sore and the context or the history of the sore. Visual exam of the sore is when you look at the sore and examine the sore, and the context of the sore consists of how the sore, what's causing the sore, how the sore is evolving over time, the incubation period of the sore. So 70% of the diagnosis comes from the visual exam of the sore, actual examination of the sore, and 30% comes from the context of the sore or the history of the sore. So we're going to talk about each part, visual exam of the sore and context of the sore, in more details. Context or history of the sore. So 30% of the diagnosis come from the history or context of the sore. Context of the sore usually confirm the diagnosis. Visual exam establish the diagnosis and context confirm the diagnosis. The first part of the context of the or the history of the sore is what's causing the sore. Herpes, unlike canker sore, is infectious condition, and it's caused by herpes virus, and it's caused by skin-to-skin contact. Canker sore is usually caused by minor trauma, and it can be a small bite, or it can be even eating a spicy food. So one caused by infection, which is herpes, and another caused by minor trauma. Another part of the context or the history of the sore that differentiate between herpes and canker sore is herpes sore usually preceded by nerve pain and prodrome period. So it comes before the sore appearance, before the herpes sore appearance. Canker sore does not have prodrome period and nerve pain. Prodrome period is non-specific systemic symptoms of weakness, fatigue, muscle aches, fever, chills. They called non-specific because other conditions, such as flu, sinusitis, COVID, can give you mononucleosis, can give you the same systemic symptoms. Nerve pain, when herpes enter the body, it usually travel along the nerve during the flare-up. And during the flare-up, people can have tingly feeling and shooting pain. So it can be two types of nerve pain, tingly feeling and shooting pain. And usually the nerve pain precede the sore appearance as well. And it's usually on the side of the sore. Another part of the context or the history of the sore is herpes have go through multiple stages. Canker sore has only one stage. So herpes usually, as we said earlier, has prodrome period and nerve pain preceding the appearance of the sore. Then you're gonna have a redness of the area. The red area gonna get multiple bumps. Bumps gonna, over time gonna turn into the blister. The roof of the blister come off, you're gonna end up having open sore. Sore get crusted a little and it heals over time. The entire process can take about a week. Canker sore, unlike herpes, usually formed from minor trauma, and it starts with a sore. Sore can get bigger and deeper, but it stays in one stage, sore stage, and it heals. Another important aspect of the history of the sore is amount of pain the person is experiencing with canker sore and herpes. Herpes sores usually hurt a lot, and the degree of pain is usually described as 7 out of 10. And the pain is usually persistent. It means that the pain is being experienced all the time, and it's going to get even more aggravated with a touch. So it's a persistent baseline pain aggravated with a touch. With the canker sore, the pain is a bit less. It's about 4 out of 10 and not persistent. It usually hurts when you touch the area, or the food touches the area, or the area is stretched. A visual exam of the sore. So in this part, we're gonna learn how we can differentiate visually between canker sore and herpes. As I mentioned earlier, 70% of the diagnosis come from the visual examination. When we start the visual examination, we have to pay attention to the area affected. So herpes, unlike canker sore, prefer to affect transitional area. So it's an area where the skin turn into the mucosa. So it's usually outside of the mouth. Canker sore usually affect the inside of the mouth mucosa itself. General appearance of the sores. When we look at the canker sore is usually solitary. It's usually singular sore. It's usually oval shaped and red edges, and the center is usually white or yellowish center. The herpes, unlike canker sore, has multiple sores clustered together, and they're irregularly shaped. Each sore is irregularly shaped close to each other. And the base of the sore is usually having clear fluid, transparent fluid, or it's crusted depending on the herpes stage. Herpes sores usually clustered together, so multiple sores located close to each other and sharing usually the same red base. Canker sore usually solitary lesion, meaning it's only one canker sore present. But if more than one canker sore there, so they're usually separated by normal tissue. It means that they're not very close to each other and they're not touching each other. Herpes sore usually affect one part of the body, and it's either left side or right side. Yes, it can affect both parts of the body, but more commonly on one side. Canker sore, if multiple sores present, it usually can affect different part of the mouth, left and right at the same time. Herpes sore, unlike canker sore, very superficial. It affects the very top layer of the skin and mucosa. Canker sore can go a little deeper inside, and you can see the difference by pinching the area or with the lesion. And you can see, you can feel the hardness under your finger. It means that the lesion is penetrating the area well. It means that the lesion is deeper. With a canker sore, you feel the hardness under your finger when you touch the area. This is the end of herpes to canker sore comparison. Now I'm gonna turn to you, asking you if the video was helpful. And if it was helpful, please click like and leave your comments in the comment section so we can answer your question. Let us know which other videos you would like to see. And please support our channel by subscribing. Thank you.